American college students throw away 4.5 million pounds of food every day. That's 1.6 billion pounds of food every year, or the weight of 48,000 apple cart buses. And that's just from college students. Food waste flows freely here in Boone, in our cafeterias, restaurants, and in our homes. What we hope to show you is how food is wasted every day and what you can do to change that. So why are we doing this? Why are we throwing away food so easily without feeling guilty? Without thinking, when can I use this later? Or who else could eat this if I don't? What factors of our society have allowed us to get to this point? What influences our economy have on us? Are there governmental pressures? What role do our mindsets play in the way we waste food? What makes us blur the line between what is usable food and what is unusable garbage?
Food waste is a modern problem. Therefore, the causes are within our modern society. Our government gives farmers economic incentives which encourage them to produce as much food as possible. This creates a surplus that drives down prices at the grocery store and allows consumers to spend a great deal less of their income on food. When food is cheap and abundant, it loses its value and consumers are more likely to waste it.
Plate to plate, it's, you know, I would say, let's say an average of 4 to 6 ounces maybe on a plate. A pickle chip and a, you know, a grape or a corner of a sandwich or whatever it might be.
Not only is our government encouraging food waste through conventional agriculture, it also influences food waste through health and sanitation laws. Major commercial grocery stores keep very high stock of the food they sell in order to maximize profits, but FDA laws require food to be thrown away when it passes the sell-by date. The sad reality of the system is that viable food winds up in landfills, where it will never be consumed or turned into valuable compost. Restaurants run into a similar problem. Many food providers pre-cook a portion of their meals to provide customers with fast service, and they often overestimate. Once food is pre-prepared, its shelf life is drastically shortened and it must be thrown away earlier. In a nation of high ideals, the label of garbage is applied to anything less than perfect or desirable, and the notion that this garbage could be salvaged and consumed is taboo.
By changing our individual habits, we can help redefine America's cultural philosophy of food and garbage. When we take steps against food waste, our mindsets begin to change, while radical ideals become household routine. Some places are implementing changes to alter the state of food waste. One of these is Warren Wilson College, where we went to learn more about their composting program. By chance, we discovered something deeper.
And a big problem with that is the philosophy of trash, and that trash is taboo in our culture. The trash never leaves us. Even when we are reusing it and turning it into other things, it's still with us, and that it's never going to go away. It's a renewable resource, essentially. And we can use it, and we can compost it, and we can turn it into soil, and it doesn't have to go to a landfill, which is bad.
By throwing your biodegradable household trash into a compost pile and turning it over periodically, the waste breaks down into soil that can be used to cultivate a vegetable garden.
And so compost is the way that we can create soil without having to wait millions of years for the earth to do it itself, right?
Another alternative is salvaging food after it's thrown away, or as it's more commonly known, dumpster diving. Most of us are not willing to take this next step. Whether it is our fears of foodborne illnesses, being caught trespassing, or moving past the stigma of finding food from trash, our social conventions often prevent us from doing so. However, the benefits of finding a full meal that's unharmed, free, and not going to rot in a landfill somewhere far outweigh the possibility of these uncommon repercussions. Discard food so easily completely disregards the strife and the toil that went into making it so accessible. Be mindful of your food and how you waste it, and know there's something you can do about it. Don't play with your garbage when you can make a difference.
pistol shots ring out in a barroom night. Enter Betty Valentine from the upper hall. She sees a bartender in a pool of blood. Cries out, my God, they've killed them all. Here comes the story of the hurricane. The man the authorities came to blame for something that he never done. Put in a prison cell, but one time he could have been the champion of the world.
It's recording.
Tasty. I'll give you that, but back of my head, I'm eating trash.
This big fat green drum, it's
Shut up!
The way we discard food so easily completely disregards the strife and the toil that went into making it so accessible. Be mindful of your food and how you waste it, and know there's something you can do about it. Don't play with your garbage when you can make a difference.